So, how do you manage your code?
GitHub versioning version management द्वारा
Exactly. Yes.
previously we used to use TFS, then currently we are using GitHub.
What is the issue? Why did you change from TFS to GitHub?
No, not as such, but GitHub is more user friendly than TFS.
Okay, so that's the reason you are
Yeah.
using. So it's half an hour. We have been to the interview. Can we do some coding? Sure. Okay. Please share your screen and keep your iPad open. So are you aware of any API-based automations?
No, not as such.
Okay, you haven't worked on any of the API-based automations or any of the activities where you need to request or get use verbs, get post request.
Postman, I have tried, but that didn't work, so it didn't work further.
Why do you use Postman to make any API request? We already have activity
HTTP
in your
request.
yes, we already have it, right?
Yeah.
I think you should go ahead and try them. Okay. So do you have any use case where you can demo me?
No, as such, because the credentials might have changed, and you
Okay,
can.
don't go with office or your company's data. I'll just go with something that's too generic and that can be viewable. You get that can be shown. So you're using RE framework with Excel in
Yeah,
this.
yeah.
Okay. So what are the changes that you need to make sure that RE framework works with data table?
RE framework works with data table. Yeah, we
Yes.
need to change the transaction item variable to
Okay.
the data row.
Okay. Other than that, anything else? What are the different changes that you need to make? Not only with the transaction item. Okay, after changing transaction item, we may get many errors like this, where you are seeing some blue marks. So, what are the different changes that you need to make? So, how many processes have you developed in RE framework?
Two.
Only two processes you have developed so far in RE framework.
Yeah.
Okay. So are they in data table? Like the input data is in data table, or what is the input type?
Excel.
Okay, but for both,
Yes.
the input type is Excel. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So why are we having errors here? I think you missed something called transaction item in the catch block.
Transaction
And also you did not change the type, transaction item type.
Yeah.
So have you tried any process where you need to initially give the arguments to the process before it starts?
No.
Okay. So are you aware of such things like how we can do or how we can pass in the values before the process actually starts?
No.
Okay. I think you can leave your mic and just try to type in. So what are you doing? What do you want to try to do? Just say that.
Just I'm changing that argument type.
Okay.
System.data.
So we'll wait for one more minute. If you are able to solve it, then it's fine, or else we'll go with the next one.
Yeah.
Great. So while you are working on the data table, see, if you are using Orchestrator and if you are using transactions, I know that we can get the timings, when did it start and when did it stop, mm-hmm. a particular transaction item. So if you want to keep an audit log stating that this particular transaction started at this time and it stopped at this particular time, and this is the time that it took to make the make that particular transaction complete, how will you do that?
No, not sure.
Okay. Okay, so complete this.
How it can be done?
Oh, we can use stopwatch.
Stopwatch.
Yeah. Okay, the issue here is not with your code. The problem here is with UiPath Studio. So what exactly is happening is it already binded your transaction item to nothing, which is a queue. Now, okay. No, you need not do anything like that.
Okay.
Okay. Now what you need to do is click on the transaction item, double click, remove completely the transaction item. Okay, click somewhere out. Okay, now you add transaction item again.
Yeah, I tried that.
Yeah, I think now it will work. Okay, remove nothing.
No, no, see? It came out.
Okay, so what happened is the transaction item earlier was binded to queue item, and it's not allowing you to change it to
data
nothing.
Row. Yeah.
Yes. Now what happened when we remove it, the assignment statement got decoupled.
Mm-hmm.
And now the transaction item is change it back to data row. That's the reason we are able to resolve this error. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, even if you try like this, immediately checking on it, it will not work. Okay. Leave about it. Can you go into main? Okay. Can you explain me the transactions? What are transactions and what is the system exception, successful, no data, new transaction? On the right side, we have business success. What are these?
Yeah, so this is the first step in our framework where we will read the config file and we read the data into the dictionary.
Okay.
So in this stage, we will initialize all the applications and settings from config file.
Okay.
So this is the init stage. Then after that, if it gets successful, it will get the transaction data. Suppose if we are using Orchestrator queue, then we can take the data from queue, or we can add the data and we can
No, don't explain me the complete process. Just explain me how the transactions work. See the lines, the successful and exception.
Yeah, so once we get the data from whichever the database or Excel we need, then it will go to the process transaction state. It will process. If we get anything like a business exception, then it will set the transaction status in that particular wherever we are writing. So okay. If business exception is nothing, it will again get to the get transaction data and it will find for a new data.
So for a single transaction, can we add multiple paths?
Multiple
path, like see in the main, go back to the main. See, there is a single transaction from initiation state, but there are two paths, system exception and successful exception.
Yes.
So can you explain in detail about it if you are aware?
Yeah, so suppose if initialization, if system exception is nothing, then only it will go to the next step. But if we face any system exception, it will directly end the processes.
Okay, can you double click on that line?
System exception?
Yes, please double click on it. Okay. So can you explain me this particular activity? What is this?
Yeah, so this is the condition. So system exception is nothing.
And okay.
System exception is nothing, then it will go to the get transaction data.
Okay.
So which is the next step in RE framework.
Okay.
So get transaction data, once it's complete, without any means initialization is successful, it will get to the get transaction data. If get transaction data is successful, then it will process the transaction. If after one transaction is processed successfully, and again, it will go to the initial get transaction data, and it will process for the next items from the get transaction data. But if anything comes like a business exception and system exception, it will try to the get transaction data, and it will retry whatever we have mentioned. Then it will again repeat the process.
Okay. So, what are the different ways where we can check or okay, explain me about business exception. What is business exception and how do you use it?
Business exception, and suppose you are taking some data from any input, and okay, suppose if it's a numerical data and somehow by human error or something, if it comes by means characters and all, then it's a business exception.
Okay.
And system exception means suppose anything like if you are going to log in somewhere and it's not browser crashed or something, like it's kind of system exception.
Okay. Let's say that the config file that we need to initialize,
okay,
is not in the project folder.
Okay.
Okay. There is some shared repository where we are adding up all the details.
For config file?
Yes.
Okay.
So do you have any idea of how you need to remove or you need to divide the data from the code? Complete data folder should not be coupled with the code. Every time you make a code update, a data file should not, data folder should not be changed. Do you know a method how we can do that?
No.
Okay, fine. So okay, let's go back to your config file. What normally will you place in your config file?
Yeah, so this is the config file.
So there should be one more sheet, right? Other than
assets.
Yes.
I was working with Excel, so I have not used that asset sheet, but it should be somewhere.
Okay, fine. So what is the difference between asset and a credential?
Assets is the type for orchestrator, and there are four kinds of assets we can use in orchestrator, like okay, credential, string, integer, and boolean.
Okay.
So based on our requirement, we can then use whatever we want to use.
So how do you call the asset from an orchestrator? What are the activity?
we can use get assets activity to call the credentials from orchestrator.
So will get asset activity work to get the credentials from orchestrator?
Yeah, but if we use RU framework, we have one more XAML file. So get credentials. So based on that, we can fetch the credentials from either from orchestrator or Windows Credential Manager.
So that is a get credential file completely different, which you're saying. So the exact question is, what is the difference between get asset activity and get credential activity?
Assets means we are fetching the asset names from the orchestrator, and based on that, we can fetch the credentials which are used, because in credential, only for credentials types, we have username and password in orchestrator, and rest others, we don't have those username and password facility. We just need to provide that value for other credential type asset types in orchestrator.
Okay. So you're saying that since your credentials have username and password, we need to use a different activity altogether.
Yeah.
Okay. So can you explain me about get credential workflow in your RE framework, how it works? I think you can directly go and check with get credential activity. Don't we have get credential activity here? Get credential workflow here?
Yeah, that's what I'm checking. I'm not getting
here. So you can create a new workflow or a new RE framework, then you will find it. It's easier that way.
No, I think, but after updating that get credential is not there, I guess.
Okay, let's see.
Get credential is not here as well.
Okay, maybe with the new work.
It's updated.
Maybe with the new.
No, that's why.
Okay, so explain me, even though it's not available, explain me what exactly it does. What is the first step? What is the next step?
Yeah, actually it takes the credentials from orchestrator or config file. So if credentials are not there, it can be either, then it will go into the else part of the if block, and then it will ask for ask user for the credential. It will request the credentials to user, then it will add the credentials.
So first it will ask in?
First it will try to take the credentials from wherever. If it's config file, then it will take from config file. If it's in assets, then it will use assets. And if it's not, if both are not there, then it will request a credential, then it will add a credential, and then it will proceed further.
So what is Windows Credential Manager play a part in get credential activity?
If we are not using orchestrator, if we are not storing the credentials in orchestrator assets or in config file, we can use it in Windows Credentials Manager. From there, we can fetch the credentials.
So is it safe to use credentials in a config file?
No.
So why are we using credentials in a config file then?
It depends actually. If some business persons don't want to go with orchestrator and all those things, they will asked to put it in config file or use arguments in.
Is there any other method you can suggest? Because see, the best way which the credentials can be secured is in an orchestrator or Windows Credential Manager.
Yeah.
So keeping config is not the safest way.
Yes.
Okay. So what can be another way where we can add the credentials to a process?
Not sure.
Okay. The other can be a Word document, which can be password protected.
Okay.
Okay. Rather than storing the password in the config file, we need to maybe check sure or make sure that the file or make sure that the path is read only from this file, this particular window or this particular computer, using the name of the computer or using the IP of the computer, and securing it such that in other places or in other computers it doesn't open.
So that can be done from Excel as config file as well.
Yes, it can be done. We can create an Excel file with a password protect, and maybe we can add that. But as said, the best way to do it is using a Windows credential manager.
Yeah.
Because that will be stored rather than all these things.
Yes.
Properly.